definitely. What about rolling on a river?
I thought that was Tina Turner.
Hey, they say that I'm talking a whole lot of trash. I'm sitting there thinking like, who knew? I know that you've seen us on Rappers React. They talking about us on YouTube. Hollywood 6, it look like I do magic. Maybe he's practicing voodoo. I'm hearing you're getting a lot of attention. Well, I'm here to say that we do to deliver the rubbish.
What's going on, everybody? We're back with another segment of Rappers React. Hold up.
What up?
I got some trivia for you.
What you got?
Okay, what British group had the hit with the song The House of the Rising Sun in 1964? And I think we've covered this.
Yes, that was the Animals.
Good job, good job.
Yeah.
How about this? Alanis Morissette appeared on what 1980s TV show?
Was it Degrassi?
Mm-mm.
1980s. Yeah. Degrassi was a child actor.
But Degrassi was like 2000.
I think it ran for quite some time, but what was it? I can't even recall. Right,
you can't do that on television.
Oh, Nickelodeon, yeah.
All right, you want more?
Yeah.
All right, who was the first female artist in history to have 4 consecutive singles from one album reach the top 5 in the Billboard Hot 100? I have no clue who this even is.
Oh, me either.
Cyndi Lauper?
Oh, Cyndi Lauper? That was, what was her hit?
She has one.
Oh, girls, just wanna have fun.
Oh, that's her.
Yeah.
Okay.
I remember Captain Lou Albano was in the video.
Yeah, it says she's, so, who? Captain who?
Lou Albano. He was a wrestling personality, yeah. She was actually in, she spent some time in WWE, or WWF back then.
Really?
Yeah, like, Roddy Piper was involved in an angle with her, yeah.
Okay, sweet. All right, let's see. If you could say, man, like, let's say, all right, you grew up in the hood, you know? Mm. And then you could say, man, you grew up in the suburbs, you were more blank than I was.
Hood?
No, that person who grew up in the suburbs, they were more...
Oh, privileged?
Another word. Starts with an F. Okay.
I can't think of it right.
Wheel of...
Fortune. Oh, fortunate.
Okay. You have a daughter and you have a...
Son? Oh, fortunate son.
You got it, my friend! Guys, before we get started, please do us a big, big, big favor. Y'all, please hit that thumbs up button. Guys, please subscribe to the channel.
And for God's sake, leave us a comment and tell us what to react to next. This is how we get the ideas for these videos. It comes directly from you! Right down in the comment section. And to... Excuse me. Today.
Hey, now we gotta run that one back. Give me a better one. Give me a better one.
And today.
Ooh.
Creedence Clearwater Revival.
Who?
You don't know it? You've never heard of Creedence? Creedence Clearwater.
I know Cletus.
Cletus?
I know.
Oh, yeah, Cletus.
And if there's Cletus. Anybody named Cletus out there watching this, please just leave a thumbs up and let us know.
Yeah.
Just shout out to all the Cletuses.
Yeah.
But
absolutely.
I know nothing of this.
New Orleans, I believe. At least Louisiana for sure. Born on the Bayou.
Do I know that song? Damn,
oh, dude,
that sounds
you know probably more than one of their songs.
That one actually sounds familiar. Born
yeah.
on the... Do I know this song?
Maybe this. I believe this was Vietnam era.
70s.
They were actually. I mean, it almost seems like they were the sound of Vietnam.
70s, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you know the song?
Yeah. Yeah, I ain't the fortunate one, no. Yeah, I ain't no politician son or whatever he said.
I don't ring a bell in my head.
You, oh man.
Well, obviously, I'm going to be able to check it out.
You might know this one, but I know you know some of their songs.
Born on the Bayou, definitely.
What about Rolling on a River?
I thought that was Tina Turner.
That she did the remake of it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's two.
Proud Mary, keep on playing. Rolling, rolling, rolling on a river. Yeah.
Okay, so I do know some of them, but maybe I do. I might know this once it comes in.
Yeah.
But you said the soundtrack to the...
Dude, it seems like it, because anytime you see a movie based on the 70s, it seems like they're always playing Creedence Clearwater. Like anything involving the Vietnam War. Like, it seems like they have to play some Creedence.
See, when I hear the name Creedence Clearwater Revival, I think of this being like a 2010 band.
Oh no!
Like an alternative Creedence.
No, man, this was like Rolling Stones.
Wow.
That type.
Okay, so I knew Born on the Bayou and I knew Rolling on the River, but I just didn't know who sang it, you know?
Yeah, you'd probably get a bunch of other ones if we went through their catalog.
Well, let me ask you this. Do you know what this song's about?
I want to say it may have been something about the Vietnam or political... political situation of the time.
Okay, so this will be a genuine reaction for me because I've never seen it, and maybe you can make it a lyrical analysis.
Yeah, definitely. I'd like to go through it and find out.
Smoked out.
What?
Let's
do it. All tell right. me that don't sound like we in Vietnam.
I know this song.
Yeah.
I thought, what? Red, that red bag and fly. Ooh, that red, white, and blue.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I do. Why did I always think that was like Led Zeppelin or like...
Nah.
Or Leonard Skinner.
That's Louisiana boys right there.
Okay. Man. Look, let's make this a lyrical analysis.
Yeah, definitely.
I think I know what it's about, though. Iconic.
Creedence, man.
I know this song.
Yeah.
I'm kind of...
I'm telling you, you know probably a lot more than you would think.
That's... What is that about? What does that mean, knowing their songs but not knowing
because
their
name? They use them in so many movies and things.
Yeah, but why don't I know the name of the band is my question.
Good question. It was probably something you really had to seek out. Like, if you're like, what is that song I hear in all these movies?
And ooh, that red, white, and blue.
Yeah.
If I had to Google, if I'm like, ah, what's the name of the song? All I would have to Google is, ooh, that red, white, and blue. That's all I'd have to do.
Exactly.
Man, first of all, what kind of genre would you say this was?
It's kind of southern rock blues, but also...
It's got some soul in there as
Yeah, there's some soul. There's absolutely... Because a lot of those bands were getting into soul during that time. You know, the Beatles, the Rolling Stones. You know, they were... That was the sound of the times, you know.
I mean, this was... This is... If someone said, hey, we need a top five songs that represent America.
Yeah.
Would you say, like, this represents America, you know?
A portion of America, for sure.
Yeah.
The downtrodden section. growing up in the ghetto, you know, growing up in the slums. You know, that thing, that was a lot of their message, you know. We come from the bad side of town.
Yeah. You know, before we get into what we think the song's about, every single Toyota or Ford truck or Chevy commercial I've ever seen has had this in there.
Yeah.
Every crawfish broil I've ever had has had this song playing in the bright background.
Exactly.
But it's about just standing up for your country, I think. No?
Well, I think it's kind of the opposite. I think he's saying, like, you know, there's a section of America that's just, you know, full-throated, love America, you know?
Go America!
Yeah, let's go to war, let's kill them all, you know? And he's like, that ain't me. He's like, some people, you know, there's rich people out there that just got everything handed to them. That ain't me.
The fortunate son. Wow. Yeah. Okay. You bringing it like.
I ain't no millionaire son. Nah.
Okay.
It ain't me.
It ain't. Okay. Yeah. You breaking it down like that, especially with the title of the song being Fortunate Son.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
Yeah. I kind of gave two different scenarios. You know, he's like, yeah, I'm not the super flag waving patriot. You know, I'm not the let's go to war. I'm not, you know, first in line to, you know, vote and all this stuff.
But at the same time, I am proud to be American.
Yes, but I am still American, yeah.
Yes. Dang, man. This was a good one here, dude.
Yeah.
This was a good one. Yeah. To the trash talkers who have suggested, this name is a tongue twister for me, Creedence Clearwater Revival.
Yeah.
To the trash talkers and this, and everyone who have suggested this, we need more. Can I just...
Absolutely. I want to go through their whole catalog.
Let's
to tell
do
you
it.
The truth.
Is it okay to say, just refer to them as CCR?
Yes.
That's okay?
Yes.
Okay.
That's what most people do, I think.
I was going to say that, but didn't want to receive backlash from that. But yes, to everyone who suggested we do some CCR, please let us know what's next, because this is what you call good old American music.
Exactly.
100%. Guys, with that being said, my name's Behringer Hollywood Sigs. Bye.
I am Larry Smokey Ramirez Cowan.
And we are
over
and
out.
Deuces. I want to thank you guys for tuning in to another segment of Rappers React. If you guys want to see another artist that we covered, just click right here. If you want to see the last video did, just click right over here. Thank you so much for spending a little bit of time with us today. Please hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already, and we'll see you on the next one. Deuces.